Even with this rain and foreboding ice, we are still dealing with snow, and a lot of roofs already are piled high with snow. This next storm is only going to make an already bad situation even worse. Two schools were already closed because the weight of the snow was just too much for them. On Sunday, teachers noticed a buckled beam at Sacopee Valley High School's gym, and now Lebanon Elementary School, home to fourth and fifth graders, has been condemned after a scary discovery last night. News 8's Will Lewis joins us live from Lebanon tonight with all the details. Will?
Good evening, Tori, and I can tell you that engineers walked through Lebanon Elementary School this morning to do another check of how many beams were damaged. Now, they wouldn't go on camera, but they do tell me 25 of the 200 beams that hold up this roof do have some part of damage. Now, the focus does turn to this weather. If it keeps raining like it is now, that will just melt the snow and ease some of the pressure of those beams. But anything other than rain could send this roof crashing down. With direct orders not to get on the roof at Lebanon Elementary, workers try to clear as much snow as they can from a ladder. Calcium chloride from last night is helping to melt the snow, and the superintendent is working on getting children back in class.
Well, the plan is that these students here will not have school Wednesday and Thursday. We will have school Friday.
As teachers pack up supplies to move to other schools, fifth grade student Alyssa Moser is spending the day helping her mom chip ice away from their driveway. Carrie Moser is a substitute teacher at Lebanon Elementary, and with the school closed, that means less work. But Carrie is more worried about how much longer her daughter will have to be in school this year.
Because they've missed so much school so far with the weather that we've had here that I'm kind of concerned and about how much school she's going to have to make up. But compared to her brother who is in school today, I don't know how they're going to work that with one group of kids.
Other parents still can't believe their children were in danger.
By looking at it, this is probably 2, 3, maybe 4 feet in places up there. You know, I mean, we had this kind of snow back in December, and then we lost it all with melting and stuff. I mean, were they in jeopardy back then? Did it happen back then?
Engineers and the school board say there are several options to fix the broken beams. However, each option starts with clearing the snow.
The building is standing, as you can see. We intend to repair it.
And as for students, they just want to go back to class.
Because I don't get to be with my friends.
Now, you did hear Superintendent Andre talk about that plan on Friday, and this is what's going to happen. Fourth grade students will continue to catch their bus here to Lebanon Elementary, and then they will hop on another bus and go to Hussey Elementary in Berwick. Fifth grade students will attend class next door at Hanson Elementary. Now, another question that some parents had is, how do they get their kids' stuff out of the school? And I talked to Superintendent Andre, and he said what they need to do is just call the principal of Hanson Elementary, I'm sorry, and that number is 608-6862. Live in Lebanon, Will Lewis, News 8.
All right, thank you, Will. As we first told you